Yep, it's working. Hello.
It's a bit wobbly. It's going to fall off the rock.
Leave it, Ken. It's fine. It's stable.
Are you sure?
Yes.
All right.
Well, here we are in Giggleswick, North Yorkshire, on a country lane. Mary, my wife, has gone shopping in Skipton with my daughter, Karen. We're due to rendezvous with them at the guest house a little bit later on. Ken.
Yes.
You've travelled here independently, haven't you?
Yes.
How are traffic conditions?
Not bad.
Hello.
Told you.
We haven't got you anywhere to stay yet, you know.
Haven't you?
No, we haven't.
Oh.
They're full up at our guest house. Because you were a late addition to the party, weren't you, Ken?
Yes. Yes, I was.
We present the Shuttleworths. Episode 2, Mini Break in Giggleswick.
I'm surprised you found us, actually.
What do you mean?
After last week's fiasco.
Oh, yes.
Yes, because we went round and round in circles looking for that recording studio, ladies and gentlemen. We couldn't find it.
No. It's been converted into a craft centre, hasn't it?
That's right. Mm. They did very nice chocolate brownies.
They did.
Filter coffee, you know. Which made up for the disappointment of not cutting a disc.
Oh, I'm sorry, John.
Doesn't matter, Ken.
Another time.
Yeah. It's quite gloomy, isn't it?
It is.
Lots of grey clouds in the sky. It's almost as if God has cleansed his face with cotton wool and then thrown the residue into the sky.
Oh, nice image.
Do you like it?
Nice image, that.
Yeah, I just thought of it.
Oh.
In fact, it looks like it's going to rain, Ken.
Yes, it does.
I suggest we get into your Toyota and, you know, find a nice
pub.
Tea room.
Oh.
Or pub, yes.
Yes.
Oh. I'll have a lager with you, Ken.
Yes,
it'll be nice.
She is very nice. Before you kill her with a rolled up mirror, think twice. How will that bee's mother feel when she finds out her child is a ghost? Kill the bee. And ultimately, you'll have nothing to spread on your toast.
Yes, indeed. That was The Bee and the Wasp, a song which I wrote for my son Darren after I caught him swatting honeybees in the bay window of our lounge last summer. And he claimed that they were jaspers, but they weren't. They were honeybees. And I wrote that to instruct him, you know, put him right.
Jan.
But
Jan, love, can I unplug this organ now, please, because I want to brew up.
Yes. Yes, you can, Mary.
Right. Thank you.
Is that sachet of hot chocolate still available?
I have no idea.
Because ideally I'd like that.
Yes, it is. Do you want it?
Unless you want it.
No, I don't want it, no. You can have it.
Right, okay. Thank you.
Do you want a shortbread biscuit as well?
No. No thanks, love. A little bit full.
Right.
Where's Karen?
I believe she's playing ping pong with Ken.
Is she? Oh, in the lounge. I thought that Swiss couple were going to be on it all night, actually. Yeah, we're in the guest house. Just had a lovely dinner. Nice trout.
It's lovely, wasn't it?
Hey, I don't like that lady. Do you, Mary?
Which one?
Our landlady.
Oh, no.
She's got very short hair. And she's got like a kilt, isn't it? Very thick tartan skirt.
Yeah, it's a skirt, it's not
and,
a kilt.
She rushes around dead quickly, fighting everybody, you know. It's terrible. But we got a lager from the bar, which is nice, you know. We're on holiday. And it feels like we're on holiday, which is the main thing, you know.
Does it? Might do to you. Doesn't to me.
Doesn't to love.
No, it doesn't.
I'm sorry.
I mean, maybe if you switch this tape off, we'd start enjoying ourselves. But it just seems to dominate, doesn't it?
No.
I mean, people aren't going to be interested in this, are they?
Do you not think so?
No, I'm not going to want to listen to this. It's boring.
Right. Yeah. Well, I'll switch it off then.
Good.
Yeah. Bye for now.
Yeah!
2013.
15?
It's 13, Ken. Don't cheat.
Stop cheating, Ken.
Oh, I could have sworn it was 15. Because I did that clever looping shot, didn't I?
Yeah, and you were on 12 then.
Oh.
Play on 2013.
Does this mean it's match point then?
It does, I'm afraid, yes.
Oh, got my work cut out then, haven't I? Oh, sorry. It's gone in your drink.
Ken.
What is that, anyway?
Blinking idiot.
Hey, what is it?
Marguerite.
Thanks, Ken.
Margarita.
Oh, can I have some?
No.
Go on, just a little sip.
No, you're going to be too drunk to drive.
No, I'm not.
What have you had tonight?
I've had very little.
You're a very silly man.
Thank you. Oh, it's nice, that.
Karen, are you going to bed now?
Yeah, in a bit.
Come on, we've got a lot of walking to do tomorrow.
Oh, you might have.
Sing us a song, John.
No.
Please, that new one you've been working on. The Bee and the Wasp.
No, it's too late, Ken.
Oh.
In fact, you should be making a move to your guest house. Because that lady will want you off the premises fairly soon.
Oh, Jenny. No, she's all right.
She will, Ken.
All right, I'll be going presently. Hey, are you still recording?
Yes.
You are, aren't you? Can see it going round. Ha!
Ken, don't do that. You damage the equipment.
Sorry.
Night, Dad. Night, Ken.
Lay off, love. Good night.
Karen, where are you going?
I'm going to bed. I'm tired.
You can't go yet. I want to take my revenge on you.
Tomorrow, Ken.
No, now. Karen.
Shut up, Ken. You're drunk.
Yes, you are, Ken. You've gone red and a bit of saliva has appeared at your mouth, at the side of your mouth. So just calm down. It's not that important.
All right. I'm sorry. But would you please just sing a verse of your song, John?
No.
Please, John, for me. To send me on my way.
Oh, very well.
Oh, thank you.
It'll have to be a cappella, because my organ's upstairs in my room.
That's fine. And I'll play percussion on my table tennis bat.
All right.
Come on, then.
The wasp, however, is an evil fella, an insect of little worth, who buzzes in cars and around jam jars, and must be removed from this earth. So if you see in the vicinity a wasp, here's what to do. Make sure it's a wasp.
Do, do, do.
Not a bee, because
do, do, do.
If you kill a bee, I will be exceedingly cross with you.
Yes! Do, 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 do,
do, do, do.
The bee and the wasp. The bee.
Yes.
Oh!
Ken?
Ah.
Ken!
Hey, what's going on? You broke him our games table.
Yes.
Get up. Come on, get up. You're squashing the Trivial Pursuits.
Yes, but he's hurt.
I'm not interested in that. Come on, get off the jack straws.
Jenny, have you any medical facilities on site?
Is the bar still open, Jenny?
No, sir, it is not.
It isn't.
Because I'd love a margarita, if possible. Is it possible?
No, sir, it is not.
No, it isn't.
Wait a minute. Are you a resident?
Well, strictly speaking.
No. No, he isn't. He's my guest.
He's not a resident? Well, will you kindly leave, sir? Will you kindly leave?
Yes. Yes, I will, young lady.
Jenny.
Goodness me.
You don't need to speak to me like
that. Where are you going now?
Because, you know...
What are you doing now?
It was an accident, and the table will be paid for.
I'm just putting my neckerchief on. Do you mind?
Well, you can do it outside. What are you doing now?
I'm putting my bum bag on.
Well,
who do you think you are?
You can do it outside, sir.
This
come
is
on.
Outrageous.
Out you go.
Ow.
Come on.
Get
out you go.
I say.
Do you know this gentleman, sir? Do you know this gentleman?
Yes, I do.
Don't struggle. Just keep still.
Shut your gob.
You know, we're just having a quiet evening together. There's no need for this.
And did you know the gentleman before this evening, sir?
Yes, of course.
Who do you think you are? A policeman?
He's a personal friend of Marty Kane's.
Yes.
Anita Harris.
I am.
And many other celebrities.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes, sir.
Yes. yes. As a matter of fact, I am.
He was on New Faces in 1973.
Were you? Were you, sir?
Yes.
Yes.
That's funny, that, because, who was it now? I can see his face. He was on that thingy with the...
John,
come to me in
John,
a moment.
We can escape.
Who was
come
it?
On.
Yes, right.
He was on that thingy. It was on a Christmas. But, who was it? There was Paul.
Yes. Come on, this way.
Funny.
Right.
Oh, that's right. That's right, because he was doing that thingy, you know, the big fella. Big fella. Yeah,
listen to her.
What
yeah.
was his name?
Hey, that was lucky, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
It was very strange.
Are you all right?
Yes, but she gave me an Indian burn.
You know, yes, she turned very aggressive, didn't she?
Mm. I better go, John.
I don't know.
Yes, you had.
No, I'll see you tomorrow.
Don't forget your boots.
No.
And your cagoule.
Yes, all right.
Have you got a thick sweater?
Yes,
sir. I can't remember
exactly. Sure you can.
I suppose. On the tip of my tongue.
Oh, shut up.
I just can't remember.
Ideally, I would have liked to have brewed up before I retired, but Mary was asleep, and I was worried that the noise of the teas made would disturb her. It's a shame, really. I mean, I don't know why it is, but whenever we go on holiday, we always seem to fall out. Do you do that, ladies and gentlemen? We always do. Anyway, I put my pyjamas on, and I was about to get into bed, when I heard this noise like hailstones on the window. Ken, what do you want?
I'm too drunk to drive, John.
Oh, I knew you were. What are you going to do?
I don't know.
Hey, where are you going now?
I'm just going to make myself comfortable.
Oh.
Hey, that cow's saying goodnight to me.
Ken, keep your voice down.
Cow.
Shut up. You wake everybody.
He heard me.
What, have you got your camcorder?
Oh, yeah. Hey, chuck your telly out of the window.
Pardon?
And I'll video it.
What for?
Publicity purposes. It'll improve your image with the rock media. Might lead to a tour with Guns N' Roses or something. You don't know, do you?
Ken had a point. I'm aware that I'm no spring chicken, and I need something like this to improve my standing in the pop world. You know, if you want to be a rock star, you've got to behave like one. So I picked up the telly. It was a Pi, 18-inch colour. No remote, but we used to sell a lot of these when I worked for Comet back in the 70s. Very nice set in its day. And even now, far too nice to chuck out of a hotel window.
Hey, what's that?
It's a tease made. Come on, get on with it.
Where's your telly?
I'm not breaking a telly, Ken. It's not on.
Aw, I suppose it'll do. Chuck it then.
No, it'll break. I'll just pretend to.
Spoil sport. Come on then, lift it above your head. Look menacing. Oh, that's no good. You seem apologetic.
Well, I am, actually. It's a terrible thing to be doing.
Snarl, John. Oh, that's lovely. That's better. Vintage stuff. Bit more. Oh, so. Oh, hello, Jenny.
Oh, what? Oh. Sorry.
You've broken my teeth, mate.
Yes.
I want you out, Mr. Shuttleworth. First thing in the morning, you can pack your bags and leave. I ought to call the police.
All damages will be paid for.
Don't call the police, Jenny. It was an accident.
Oh, all right, sir, if you insist. Anyway, it was Frank Windsor.
Pardon?
He had the celebrity suite that I keep for celebrities.
Oh.
Where are you stopping tonight, sir?
Can I sleep on your ping-pong table?
Oh, well, you could do, sir, but the celebrity suite is available.
Is it pricey?
To you, sir, it's free. It's the least I can do after our little misunderstanding.
Oh, right.
Follow me, sir. Would you like a margarita as a nightcap?
Oh, yes, please. See you, John. Hey, it looked brilliant, you know, when it fell.
Did it?
Mm. Yes, sir. I'm confident we've got some interesting footage.
John.
Jenny.
John. Shut the window and come to bed.
Yes, Mary.
Are you brewing up? Eh?
No, I don't think so, love.
The Shuttleworths was written and performed by Graham Fellows and produced by Paul Schlesinger.